Started in 1989 when I was working for Jackson Press, and they told me that the gentleman is coming to work with me. It was the good old days that money was around and there was no problem, and was prior to the recession that we had to have, you know. And Lynn came to put Jackson Press. And he showed me this original. This is actually, it's the Art Gallery of Queensland did it, but this is the actual image that he showed us. And remember, we were talking about David Rankin. With David Rankin, he introduced me to Lynn, and we start to have a chat, and I was fascinated by a few facts that Lynn told me. The 67 referendum, I remember this was the first time that I've heard it, and as an Israeli, the 1967 was a very important date for me because of the 6 days wars, and suddenly I realized that there were some people that got the freedom just in this day. I was playing some football, and the Australian decided to let Aboriginal people to vote. Is it the...
Well, this is when they first decided they really existed.
That's right. Yeah, and they allowed, and actually I remember that Lynn told me that prior to this, they were not entitled to sign on any contract.
Yeah, well, you weren't, because you weren't a citizen. You didn't really exist, because in 67 then, and that was Lynn's father as well, who orchestrated the 67 referendum, or was one of the main people who did, along with Bill Ferguson.
Yeah.
And his brother Eric Onus. And it was before there was nothing. There was you were just like a dog, and so you couldn't sign on a contract. If you lived on a mission station, and you wanted to enter into a contract, then the head of the station would sign for you, and he'd get all the money as well. You wouldn't. And if you wanted money, if you wanted shoes or something like that, then you'd go to him and say, "I want a new pair of shoes," and he'd say, "No, you had a new pair last year. You can't have any more shoes."
Right.
And this is the same story. So, yeah, 67, this is all a change. Then we're counted on a census, so all of a sudden, Australia had hundreds of thousands of more people living in it than they had previously. even though they'd been there for 40,000 years. Mm. And I mean, you could vote and you could actually own property and do all these things that you couldn't do before. I mean, the only reason that Lynn's father, Bill, owned a house was because he was married and his wife was white, and so she could have her name on the deeds and things like this.
So prior to 67, his signature wasn't on the contract?
I don't think so. I mean, he couldn't own anything. I think you were allowed to own things with a white person.
All right, okay.
But still, then before that, there was nothing. But I mean, we're talking 67. Most people were still living on mission stations as well.
So I was introduced to this horrific fact, and then he showed me this painting. It was a gouache. And he said to me, I remember, he said to me, everything starts from black. And that's the reason that I thought it's important to sort of to start the whole idea with black. And this particular one, sort of, it's black on black, on gray, on white, white paper. And sort of the whole idea here, which is, you know, it was some sort of collaboration that we did in the lunch break, it was to do with the idea that that every print that I did with Lynn started with black. This one was a background that I just found the paper in there and nobody needed, so I sort of did few bits and pieces. So I that's the reason that I think we have to start. So all the prints that we did afterwards, and I worked with Lynn till his death in 1996, And then, in 89, Tiriki was 8 years old, and he probably was 6 foot tall then as well, but this is another topic. I'm not Jenny Craig. And then we started to work together with, I worked with Tiriki a little bit, and this exhibition is some sort of a collaboration between the three of us, Lynn, Tiriki and myself, and we thought it's sort of, obviously it's the whole idea is it's a memory to Lynn, and in a way this white bull is a memory to Lynn as well, sort of just to recognize that he was the one that told me about the whole idea of the oppression that I've learned from Josel Bergner prior to this, but basically it was with a lot of facts and from a person that was part of it. So, and actually the White Bull, the whole exhibition was dedicated to the memory of Lynn. So now to maybe we'll start with with number 1, 2, 3. What do you reckon?
Yeah? Sherlock, yeah,
you know, it's a very logical idea. Let's start from number 1.